everybody, and welcome to our final week of our workshops. And it's week not one, not two, not three, not four, not five, not six, not seven, eight, nine, but week 10. That's right. And we are going to have a little look back to see some of the wonderful things that we have done throughout all 10 weeks.
Arr, me arties. Are you ready to sing your pirate song or walk my pirate ship plank? Let's get ready with the music. Let's give it a go.
Yo-ho, yo-ho, a pirate's life for me. We pillage and plunder, we rifle and loot. Drink up, me hearties, yo-ho. We kidnap and ravage and don't give a hoot. Drink up, me hearties, yo-ho. Yo-ho, yo-ho, a pirate's life for me.
Abracadabra, abracazam, make that crayon go kabam! A tiger! But we do like to go on our holidays. And even sharks like to go on holidays. Okay. Where do sharks like to go on holidays? To Finland! On a super sonic spin! Thank you for the music, the songs I'm singing. Thanks for all the joy they're bringing. Who can live without it? I ask in all honesty, what would life be?
Has a lovely crown on.
What a load of fantastic things that we done over the whole 10 weeks. But it's not over yet. This week we have one more theme. And it's my most favourite theme ever. This is all about friendship. Friendship is one of the most wonderful things in the world, boys and girls. That's right, we all have friends, and it's good to be kind, and it's good to be nice. And when we have a friend that's kind and nice, that makes us feel happy, doesn't it? Now, I know lots of you would be missing your friends while you've been off school. So today we're going to learn a few things that you can do to impress your friends and even some crafts. Now, the first thing that we're going to do today is our poem. And this poem is by Ken Nesbitt. Now this poem is a little bit different because it's not exactly on friends that you make at school, but maybe some of the friends that you might have in your house. Now, I know that your brothers and your sisters can be your friends too, and your aunties and uncles, or your cousins. We can have lots of friends from all different places. And this one talks about how they let their friend or their sister do something that we might all have experienced during lockdown. They had to cut their hair. Would you trust your sister or your brother or your mommy or your daddy or whoever is lucky enough to be watching you to give your hair the snip? I let my sister cut my hair. I had to get a haircut. It was looking much too long. I let my sister cut it. I mean, what could she do wrong? She clipped some bald spots here and there. She whacked the sides a little, and then she shaved a 3-inch stripe directly down the middle. She chopped some sections super short, left others long and wild. Then shaved one eyebrow off before she looked at me and smiled. I don't think that I'll let her give me haircuts anymore. Or maybe I'll just wait a while. At least until she's 4. Uh-oh, boys and girls. I don't think anybody under 3 should be left alone with scissors or with hair clippers. That should only be done by somebody old enough to use them. Isn't that right, boys and girls? Mm-hmm. I don't think I would let my sister chop my hair. Mm-mm. No way. What about you? Has anybody here let anybody else cut your hair other than the hairdresser or the barber? And we definitely know that we should never ever cut our own hair. Isn't that right, boys and girls? That's right. Now, let's try it together. Are you ready?
I am.
I let my sister cut my hair. I had to get a haircut. It was looking much too long. I let my sister cut it. I mean, what could she do wrong? She clipped some bald spots here and there. She whacked the sides a little, and then she shaved a 3-inch stripe directly down the middle. She chopped some sections super short, left others long and wild.
then
shaved one eyebrow off. Before she looked at me and smiled. I don't think that I'll let her give me haircuts anymore. Or maybe I'll just wait a while, at least until she's 4. Well done, boys and girls. Give yourselves a really, really big clap. I think this little boy or this little girl really loved their sister a lot, not to get angry. And that's a sign of a really good friend, isn't it? When they make a mistake, that you're there to support them. That's right, boys and girls. Give yourselves a really, really big pat on the back. Now, boys and girls, one film that's all about friendship is Toy Story. That's right. Even boys and girls have their toys as their friends, and the toys are friends with each other. Isn't that right, boys and girls? Have you got a favourite toy? I know I do. This, boys and girls, is Pinky. Now, I've had Pinky since I was only very, very tiny, and she has gone everywhere with me, along with my Cookie Monster, and they are my favourite toys. Isn't that right, Pinky? Mwah! They're like my best friends. So, boys and girls, what we're going to learn today is you've got a friend in me. That's right. But we're going to learn it a little bit differently. This time, we are going to learn it with a little bit of sign language. So we're going to sing and sign together. First bit that we're going to learn today is you've got a friend in me. Let's try that. We point out for you. You've up to our chins for got hands together for friend. Friend in me. And we point to ourselves. Let's try that again. You've got a friend in me. That's right. Let's try it one more time. You've got a friend in me. Well done, boys and girls. The next bit we're going to learn is when the road looks rough ahead and you're miles and miles from your nice warm bed. When the road looks rough ahead and you're miles and miles from your nice warm bed. That's it, boys and girls. So we're going to do road, rough, and bed. Very good. Let's try it again. Road, rough, and bed. Last time. Road, rough, and bed. Very good. Now, boys and girls, practice your signing while I sing and sign for you, and then we'll sing it together. So, remember to sign. You've got a friend in me. You've got a friend in me. When the road looks rough ahead, and you're miles and miles from a nice warm bed. You just remember what your old pal said. You've got a friend in me. You've got a friend in me. Well done, everybody! Very good! Okay, are you ready to try and sing it and sign it? Let's give it a go. You've got a friend in me. You've got a friend in me. When the road looks rough ahead, and you're miles and miles from your nice warm bed, you just remember what your old pal said. You've got a friend in me. You've got a friend in me. Well done, boys and girls. Give yourselves a big clap. Let's try it one more time. You got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. When the road looks rough ahead, and you're miles and miles from a nice warm bed, you just remember what your old pal said. You got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. And girls, big pat on the back. Very good. So, boys and girls, wasn't that a lot of fun? We learned to sing and sign. You've got a friend in me. You've got a friend in me. Wow, I think that will really impress your friends, won't it, boys and girls? Now, we know that song is from Toy Story. But who was best friends in Toy Story? Let's see if you can guess who were really good friends. Okay, boys and girls, one nice way of showing your friends how much you care about them is by making them a friendship bracelet or bangle. And now I'm going to show you how to make a really easy one. So we're going to start with two pieces of coloured string or thread or wool. Mine's I've chosen are yellow and orange. So we want to knot the two pieces at the top together. So turn them around your fingers, pull it through, and tighten up your knot. Just like that. Because we're going to put some beads on it and we don't want them becoming loose. So the first thing I'm going to do is I have chosen a little green sparkly heart. Now this is like a little button, so we can see we have two little holes in it. We will take the first string, I'm taking my yellow and I'm threading it through the hole. And I'm pulling it right up to the top. That's it. Just like that. And then I'm going to take my orange string and pop it through the top here. There we go. It's through and we are going to give it a little pull out. That's it. So we've got our heart right at the top. Now I'm going to put a red sparkly one on, just by doing the same thing, boys and girls. So here goes my red, and I'm going to pull it up to the top. That's it. And then same with my orange. I'm going to pop it through. That's it. In it goes. And then we will pull it out. Oops. Being a little bit temperamental. Let's see. There we go. In through. And pull it out. Now, boys and girls, I made a little knot at the end of my green one. So I'm going to make another knot just at the end of my red one. And this is going to stop our beads moving about. So a wee knot, twirl it through, and pull it through. That's it. And let's pull it up, do the red bead, and tighten. That's it. So we've got green and red. Now I'm going to put another green one on. So here goes my red. And I'm going to pull it up to the top. That's it. And then same with my orange. I'm going to pop it through. That's it. In it goes. And then we will pull it out. Oops. Being a little bit temperamental. Let's see. There we go. In through. And pull it out. Now, boys and girls, I made a little knot at the end of my green one. So I'm going to make another knot just at the end of my red one. And this is going to stop our beads moving about. So a wee knot, twirl it through, and pull it through. That's it. And let's pull it up, do the red bead, and tighten. That's it. So we've got green and red. Now I'm going to put another green one on. So my third one is on. It's a little green one. And we're going to do the same thing. I'm going to put a little knot at the end. So tie it round your finger. Pull it through. That's it. Both strings. And tighten up your knot. Just like that. So we've got three. I think I could put one more on before finishing our bracelet. And my final little red heart is on, boys and girls. And what do we do? We put a little knot at the end. Okay, so there we go. We've got all our little hearts on and our two strings. Now we're going to cut these shorter, but you might need a little help from mum or dad, or whoever's lucky enough to be watching you, to be nice and careful with the scissors. So I'm going to cut mine just about here, so we have a little bit of room. So very carefully with the scissors, we watch fingers, we chop. That's it. Here is our bracelet. I wonder what it will look like on. Here we are, boys and girls. Here's my lovely friendship bracelet. Now, if you want to make one that's a little trickier, you can get three strings and plait them together. And then you could put your beads on top. Just like this, boys and girls. And then we tie the two ends together on our wrist. Just like this. There we go, my friendship bracelets. So boys and girls, not only did I make some friendship bracelets, but I also made all my friends. Wait, do we say? I made some paper dolls, boys and girls. That's right. All like my friends. Watch my little video and you can make your own. Thank you. Okay, boys and girls, I couldn't go without getting you to sing a song from the greatest showman. And this is a brilliant song because it teaches us that with good friends behind us, we can do anything. Isn't that right? No matter what is in front of you, you can go ahead with friends. This is me. Okay, boys and girls, so we're gonna try this one. Have a little listen and try and sing along. Then we'll do it together. I'm not a stranger to the dark. Hide away, they say, 'cause we don't want your broken parts. I've learned to be ashamed of all my scars. Run away, they say, no one will love you as you are. But I won't let them break me down to dust. I know that there's a place for us, for we are glorious. When the sharpest words wanna cut me down, gonna send a flood, gonna drown them out. I am brave, I am bruised, I am who I'm meant to be. This is me, look out, 'cause here I come. And I'm marching on to the beat I drum. I'm not scared to be seen, I make no apologies. This is me. Great work, boys and girls. And remember, we're going to sing along next. Let's do it together. And imagine all your friends standing behind you, marching along too. I'm not a stranger to the dark. Hide away, they say, 'cause we don't want your broken parts. I've learned to be ashamed of all my scars. Run away, they say, no one will love you as you are. But I won't let them break me down to dust. I know that there's a place for us, for we are glorious. When the sharpest words wanna cut me down, gonna send a flood, gonna drown them out. I am brave, I am bruised, I am who I'm meant to be. This is me, look out, 'cause here I come. And I'm marching on to the beat I drum. I'm not scared to be seen, make no apologies. This is me. Fantastic, boys and girls. That was really, really good. Give yourselves such a big clap. Boys and girls, so before we finish, we are going to think about all the words of what friendship means. It could mean trust. It could mean loyalty. It can mean to be kind or loving or considerate. Can you think of any others, boys and girls? So boys and girls, this is our last workshop, and I hope you've had so much fun through all 10 weeks. I hope you sung lots, you said a lot of poems, or told a lot of stories. I hope you played with puppets. I hope you had so much fun with your crafts, or even painting your face. And I am so glad I got to take these workshops with you. Bye!